Wall from space.com.
Mike, I have you a little bit faint, but I can hear you. Just keep talking loudly.
Okay, great. Thanks for taking the time to chat. This is a really packed mission, and I mean, you guys are very busy, so I really appreciate it.
Oh, it's a pleasure. I love being out here in the water. I was just commenting as we were setting up the camera this morning. Usually we're so focused when we're doing our work outside that we don't get to really appreciate the fish around us. But the fish out here this morning are just super interesting, and it's really just a pleasure to be out here.
Yeah. Could you just give me a brief what you're doing today, and like, what are you doing right now? You're on sort of a simulated spacewalk, right?
Right. So right now, in our super light gear here, which is obviously providing me the air, but it is like a super, it is trying to demonstrate that I'm on a spacewalk. So every morning we put on our wetsuits and we gear up, just like we did on the International Space Station when we send people out for an EVA. Now, unlike when we go out for a spacewalk in space and we have to do a whole pre-breathe protocol and those things, thankfully, we're living at saturation here in the Aquarius habitat, so we don't have to do all of that pre-breathe protocol, but we do have a suit-up protocol. It only takes about 15 to 20 minutes to get into the wetsuits, to get our helmets on, to get all of our tools on, and then to get out the what we call the wet porch, which is our staging area, and out to doing our spacewalks. The first few days that we've been down here, this is our fifth day, we have looked at translation methods that would require being in very close proximity, in fact, tethering to an asteroid. So we looked at tethers that were tightly pulled, and we've used what we call a boom. It's basically a really long pole. We've also had an opportunity to use jetpacks, which I gotta tell you is so much fun.
Yeah, I mean, it certainly looks like a lot of fun out there. You guys are down by a coral reef, right? You got a lot of colorful fish. It looks like a lot of fun.
It is, but it's also very focused. Again, like I pointed out, we are here to do science and to understand things here on Earth before we spend large amounts of money and go out into space. So we're learning a lot here, figuring out what works and what doesn't work before we go out into space.
Yeah, right. And yeah, I mean, that is the goal, is by about 2025 to actually send astronauts to an asteroid. You guys think that like what we're doing now is like it's going to be key to reaching that milestone, right?
Absolutely. Exploration is essential, but you have to do a lot of good research beforehand. Obviously, we would want to send out some sort of robotic precursor before we went to the asteroid. Then we would want to send humans there, but we'd want to have a good plan. And so we're doing some of that early work, like I said, so that we'll have a good plan when we go to explore an asteroid.
Do you want to be one of those astronauts to go out there 2025 or so?
I'm sorry. When I breathe, sometimes I miss what you said. Could you repeat?
I was just going to ask, I mean, do you want to be one of the astronauts to go out to an asteroid on one of those deep space missions?
Well, I would love to explore further in our solar system, and as a former astronomy teacher, that would just be really special. But I think that belongs to some of the folks that are studying right now. I am enjoying doing this exploratory work, and I think that what I'm doing is going to help pave the way for our future explorers. I'm really hoping that someday I get to go to the International Space Station to continue that type of science up there. But either way, I'm happy to do whatever NASA wants me to do. I really enjoy my job.
Yeah. Hey, great. What's it like living undersea for about 12 or 13 days or so? How does it compare to a space shuttle mission?
Well, it is very, very much a like a shuttle mission. When we were on the shuttle, we were there in space for 15 days. We had a lot to get done, including spacewalks and delivering 6 tons of cargo. Here in the Aquarius habitat, we have a very aggressive spacewalk agenda. We are doing two people out the door in the morning and two in the afternoon, which requires at least one person being the crew member inside speaking to the spacewalkers. And the other crew member is doing a lot of public outreach. They're doing this comms away research, too, where we're having about a 50-second one-way comms away. They're helping with just the normal upkeep of the Aquarius. And then we also have two habitat technicians that are living with us who really know this facility. They really understand Aquarius inside and out. And so they're keeping us safe, and that would be a lot like our commander and our pilot did on the shuttle, where all of us understood the systems, but the commander and pilot were really keeping everything going, too, in addition to all the other tasks. So there are several similarities, although, of course, the shuttle mission was to build the International Space Station, and our use of Aquarius is to help us understand exploring an asteroid.
Okay, thank you so much for your time, Dottie. I really appreciate it.
Thank you, Mike. Have a really great day. I wish you could join me here under the sea.
Yeah, it looks like a lot of fun. I wish I could, too. See ya.